Welcome to the video series on understanding sampling and weighting in the demographic and health surveys. This video series is divided into four parts. Part 1 will provide an introduction to sampling procedures used in the demographic and health surveys, also known as the DHS. Part 2 will introduce the principles behind sampling weights in the DHS. Part 3 will demonstrate how to weight DHS data in STATA. And Part 4 will demonstrate how to weight DHS data in SPSS and SAS. This video is part 2 of the series, Introduction to the Principles of DHS Sampling Weights. This video is a continuation of the material covered in part 1. If you have not watched part 1, I would encourage you to watch it before continuing forward with this video. At the end of the part 2 video, viewers will be able to explain the goals of weighting, understand the importance of weighting, and explain the concepts of over and under sampling. Similar to the Introduction of Sampling Procedures, Part 1 video, some of the topics we'll be covering are difficult topics to cover in a short YouTube video. We will try not to use very technical statistical language in order to make the subject easier to understand. The goal of this video is for you to understand conceptually the weighting of data in the DHS survey. While we will be explaining weighting concepts using numbers and math, there's no need for DHS users to be doing these calculations on their own. Similar to Part 1, we'll be using the 2012 Tajikistan Demographic and Health Survey as an example throughout the video. You can follow along with this video using the 2012 Tajikistan DHS as a reference. You can find a free PDF copy of the Tajikistan report by going to our website, www.dhsprogram.com, then clicking on the Publication tab and searching for Tajikistan. Before continuing forward, I want to provide an overview for those not familiar with the Republic of Tajikistan. The Republic of Tajikistan is a small landlocked country located in the southeastern region of Central Asia. The capital of Tajikistan is Dushanbe. The five regions of Tajikistan are included in this table. We will be referring to them as Dushanbe, Gebal, Sugd, DRS, and Hatlan. As discussed in Part 1, the statistical agency under the President of the Republic of Tajikistan, in conjunction with the sampling experts at DHS, calculated that for the 2012 Tajikistan DHS, we needed to interview 6,675 households in order to get reliable estimates for our indicators at the national level, for urban and rural areas, and for each of the five regions. For demonstration purposes, let's imagine that we want to take a sample of households with proportional allocation in Tajikistan, meaning that we select a number of households from each region exactly in proportion to the distribution of households of that region in the country. This pie chart shows the distribution of households by region in Tajikistan. Like most countries, the population is not evenly distributed among the five regions. The Sugd region includes 33% of the country, while a smaller region like Gebal contains only 3% of the population. What problems might we encounter if we took a sample of 6,675 households with a proportional allocation based on this distribution? Well, there would be very few respondents from certain regions like Gebal and Dushanbe. Too few respondents in each of these regions will not give us precise data. So let's look at how a sample of households with proportional allocation would be divided across Tajikistan's five regions using the target sample size of 6,675 households. Since only about 3% of the population lives in Gebal, a proportional allocation would only give Gebal 180 households, or 2.7% of 6,675 households. Can we obtain precise estimates on fertility and mortality for Gebal by selecting only 180 households? Well, the answer is no. 180 households is not an adequate sample size to obtain reliable estimates on fertility and childhood mortality for this region. If you recall from the first video, some of the indicators included in DHS surveys, like fertility and childhood mortality, require a minimum sample size of 800 to 1,000 women. It is highly unlikely that we'd be able to interview 800 to 1,000 women from just 180 households in Gebal. However, due to resource constraints, we can't simply increase the overall sample size of 6,675 households to ensure each region has enough households to have 800 to 1,000 women to interview. To solve this problem, we must oversample the small regions such as Gebau and undersample the large regions such as Sugd in order to obtain representative data for each region under controlled cost. The goal of DHS surveys is to provide representative data at the national and subnational levels. In many countries, the population is not evenly distributed among different regions. Oversampling in regions with small populations ensures that they have a large enough sample to be representative. Undersampling is done in regions with large populations in order for the survey to be cost-effective. So back to Tajikistan. In order to include enough households to provide representative data at the regional level, we must oversample in the regions with smaller populations and undersample in regions with larger populations. The total number of households in the sample, around 6,675, remains the same, but the households are redistributed as to select more households in smaller regions. Even though regions like Sugd have been undersampled, we are confident that our sample of 1,455 households is large enough to produce reliable estimates. Oversampling in Gebau has ensured that we have enough households, 795, to be confident that our estimates will still be reliable. Dushanbe was also oversampled and has the largest sample size because it is an urban-only region. So you might be thinking, we have a problem here. Because of oversampling, Gebau now represents 12% of the DHS sample, when that region only makes 3% of the population, and because of undersampling, Sugd is only 22% of the DHS sample, when in reality, that region makes up around 33% of the population. This can be a problem because estimates for Tajikistan as a whole will be biased, since the distribution of regions in our sample is dramatically different than the actual regional distribution of Tajikistan. This might be better clarified with an example. Remember, because of oversampling, women in Gebau now make up 12% of the sample, instead of their 3% of the population. And women in Sugd now make up 22% of the sample, instead of their 33% of the population. So you can see this is a problem, because women in Gebau are contributing too much to the national total, while women in Sugd are contributing too little. To restore the representativeness of the sample and to correct for this deliberate over and under sampling, DHS applies sampling weights to the sample. So I bet you're wondering, what exactly is a weight? The technical definition of a weight is an inflation or representative factor applied to each case in tabulations, which is in relation to the overall probability of selection and interview for each case in a sample, either due to design or happenstance. Okay, that's great for technical jargon, but what does this mean in practice? Well, a weight is a number that is multiplied to each case, whether that be a woman, child, household, couple, etc., to weight up or weight down that observation. If under or over sampling was applied, means an interviewed case would represent that number of similar cases in the population. For example, if an interviewed woman in a survey has a normalized weight of 1.2, she would represent 1.2 similar women in the total survey population. If a household in a survey has a normalized weight of 0.8, it would represent 0.8 households in the total survey population. To take into account or adjust for disproportionate sampling and non-response, DHS weights the data. Weights are used to restore the representativeness of the sample so the total sample looks like the country's actual population. As standard practice, DHS always uses weights when performing statistical analysis, and we strongly recommend that weights be included in any statistical analysis that you conduct with DHS data. Once we apply weights to the 2012 Tajikistan DHS data, the weighted number of households from Gebau is only 160 out of 6,432, which is close to Gebau's true percentage share of the population. Similarly, in Sugd, the weighted number of households is 2,069 out of 6,432, which is close to Sugd's true percentage share of the population. You might notice that the numbers in the slide are showing the actual and weighted numbers of households interviewed, which is less than the target number of households which was calculated by the samplers. Remember that not all households selected provide an interview. You can look in more detail at the response rates for the Tajikistan DHS on page 11 of the final report. To recap, in the end, after applying weights, we have a distribution that looks very much like the distribution we began with. But the advantage is that we are confident that every region has a large enough sample for the result to be representative at the subnational level. This may not be true for a sample with proportional allocation. Many people have been taught to worry about small sample sizes. However, that refers to the unweighted number of respondents, which are generally not shown in DHS tables. Most DHS tables show the weighted number of households and respondents, and this sometimes may appear to be rather small. Even if you see a small number in the table, don't worry, because this number might be much smaller than the unweighted number of cases we actually interviewed. To help you assess the sample size, the tables in the final report use certain symbols to let you know if the number of unweighted cases is too small to be considered reliable. For indicators that are percentages, parentheses indicate that a number is based on 25 to 49 unweighted cases. This means that the number should be interpreted with caution. An asterisk indicates that a number is based on less than 25 unweighted cases. This is too small to be reliable, so DHS tables do not even show these numbers. This concludes part 2 of the video series, Introduction to Sampling and Weighting in the DHS. We hope that you can now explain the goals of weighting, understand the importance of weighting, and can explain the concept of over and under sampling in the DHS. Now, since you have an overview of the principles of DHS sampling weights, we highly encourage you to check out part 3 and part 4 of this video series, which examines how to weight data in a statistical program.